Do you want to get a bad time?
I want to finish my tea! Jesus Christ, Lilac! Oh, that's a new one. Ugh. Welcome back to Freedom Planet, everybody. Well, if you didn't like Lilac before, maybe you do now. Quite the saucy lady she is. So I had been about to explain the translation of this sign here, and I'd like to take a moment to just appreciate the fact that Mayor Zhao is the biggest megalomaniac I think I've ever seen. Got big old statues of himself right out here. Got his name plastered all over this building. That sign, it's a little bit perplexing to me. Only one of those letters is actually kanji. The other three appear to be simplified Chinese characters. Although, maybe that's not technically correct. I don't know if simplified Chinese does still count as kanji. Somebody who is more familiar with the Chinese language than I am could weigh in on that, probably. But the only one that I recognize there is the second one, which in Japanese is pronounced mono, or butsu, depending. Mono is the Japanese pronunciation, butsu is the Japanese onyomi pronunciation, the Japanese approximation of the original Chinese. The other three appear to be simplified Chinese, but based on the kanji that I think they're intended to represent, and again, I'm just going with a wild guess here, but the first two seem to they seem to represent a phrase or word that implies shopping, like the act of shopping. And then the second two, as far as I can tell, are again, the third one, I'm not sure, but the fourth one is the same one we saw before that I believe is meant to represent a place, like a meeting place or a central place. So my very vague general guess at this sign is shopping center or shopping mall. Again, somebody who is better at Chinese than I am can possibly weigh in on this and be of much more benefit, and frankly, I would very much appreciate that if anyone cares to, but let's proceed. Looks like our good buddy Serpentine is not going to give up the chase quite so easily. But look at this place. The variety of environments to which this game has introduced us so far, in what, 2-3 levels? Already we've seen complete wilderness, we've seen temples, we've seen urban residential areas and shopping districts. And now we are just straight up inside a modern shopping mall with escalators and enemies that are speakers. And now it looks like we get a better look at the sign that was outside. This is the same sign. So if anybody can shed some light on this, definitely appreciate it. Let's see what we've got up here. Okay, excellent. The shield. Oh, and the invincibility shield. I think this shield, because this is, I guess, technically a sixth, this might be intended to represent the Chinese element of void. And in the Chinese elemental system, this, I guess void is more of a non-element than an actual element. But I love that there's a skylight in this mall. We can actually see the ceiling. Another thing I really appreciate is the fact that we can change the direction of the escalators by hitting that button. And we can enter the ladies' room. God, I know I've said it about 12 times in the previous episode, but these little touches, they're just such wonderful things. A little attention to detail, and we haven't even begun scratching the surface of just what's going on inside this mall. me head back for a moment. Let's take another look at that thing I just jumped on. First of all, we've got food court tables whose umbrellas you can bounce on. Then there's this crazy spinny thing. And this is apparently what we were meant to use this shield for. So let me see if I can get up there. This TV, I am not totally sure about. They seem like they should do something, but I don't know what. I don't know. I think expecting to jump into it and end up on the Midnight Channel might be a little bit much to ask, but if anybody has any idea whether those things actually are used for anything, please let me know in the comments because I'm very curious. I think there might also be something up here. Yeah, there's some stuff. Ah, yes! Oh, and this is another thing. I'll check this out in a minute, but let me, this configuration with the gems here, I love it because if you come here without this shield, it'd take you forever and be almost impossible to gather up all of those gems. But the shield allows you to just fly through once and get all of them. Now check this out. Look at this! This disco ball! This light filter and the sparkles and the fact that when you idle near it, you dance! Guys, if you are not sold on this game by now, I don't know what will sell you. Maybe the upcoming stages, because my god, is there ever more? And that's one of the things, this game just continues throwing new stuff at you, stage after stage after stage, like they never run out. Damn it, and I've just lost my shield, and the fact that that enemy was just a vacuum cleaner, and there's this... Some of the elements of this game, and this is another thing that was interesting to me, that flying thing right there is actually... I think in English they're called party balls, or party... I don't know, something, but... normally they would be opened by pulling a string, and they would release confetti and streamers and whatnot. They're usually used at inaugural events and other special occasions, but they're a uniquely Japanese thing. They're not really Chinese, as far as I know. You only really see them in Japan, or I've only seen them in Japan. And this game, as much as it loves its Chinese influences, it does incorporate some uniquely and specifically Japanese elements as well, this being one of them, at least to the best of my knowledge. I mean, these might be used in other countries as well, but I think they originated in Japan, or at any rate are used there most often. There's also the fact that the title of the game, Freedom Planet, is written in both English and katakana, which is an exclusively Japanese alphabet. Oh, and we've got, check this out, we've got the ladies' room as usual. But we've also got a men's room here. Wonder what happens when we try and enter this. No girls allowed, idiot! It's the men's room! What can I say, guys? You can tell how much love went into this game from these little details. These orbs, by the way, as far as I can tell, gathering them gives you more opportunities to roll the die in the bonus stages after you complete a level. Alright, and I think there might be some stuff up here as well, but... Ah, yes! I love the fact that they put a disco ball in the center of these platforms, so that while you're waiting on the platform for it to reach the correct angle, you're just dancing. The fact that they use their own level geometry and mechanics purposefully like that It's so brilliant. So brilliant. It's one of the reasons I love this game. Now, these things also, these are perplexing to me. We've got these suits of armor, and you can stand behind them. And the first time that I tried recording this set of episodes, I did everything I could possibly think of, but nothing happens. I'm thinking in particular of, I can't remember whether it was the SNES or the Genesis version of the Aladdin game, but in one of those two versions of that game, you could do something very much like this by standing in just such a way that your head would position itself directly under a set of Mickey Mouse ears hanging from a clothesline, and it would get you an extra life or something like that. I don't really remember. And it looks for all the world like this is supposed to do something similar, but I have not been able to get anything like that to happen. So I don't know. If anybody knows whether this is actually a thing, please let me know in the comments. Also, what is this creepy looking eye? This is a little bit disconcerting, to be honest. Hopefully I can manage to get a shield. Damn. Nope. Oh well. I tried. The life is good, though. That always helps. Ah! Oh, hey, look! There's a sale! In English, no less. Not this game. Take that, speaker! And there is our bonus stage, so now we can actually use all of those orbs we've been gathering. Oh, alright. Fair enough! I guess we have to go up from here. I cannot actually enter this shop. And unfortunately, I don't recognize the kanji in the window there. If anybody knows what that says, I'd very much appreciate it. That one also might be simplified Chinese. But also, look at this! Bike World! And if you're playing as Carol, you can actually get a motorcycle here, because there's a fuel tank. God. I feel like there's nothing more I can say, because I'm going to be repeating myself ad nauseum about these little details. Oh, I think I'm supposed to, yeah. Have to ride this thing through the wall and back up here. I think... No, I guess there's nothing up there. Yeah, you're supposed to come here with that shield, but I don't know where to get another one. Ah! Yes, there's this. So this, there is a song printed on one of the walls somewhere here. And I don't... I'm trying to remember. 1, 3... No. I think 1, 3, 4, 5. Damn it. It's 1, 3, 4, 5, 3, 1. And I'll see if I can find the song somewhere, but damn it. 1, 3, 4, 5, 3, 1. I don't know, I have entered it successfully before, but I can't figure out what it actually does. Nothing has happened when I've tried, so... we are nearing 15 minutes. And I'm going to have to wrap the episode up, unfortunately. So thank you all for joining me, and I look forward to seeing you all next time. Take care, everyone.